Hello, my name is Jesper Sivebaek, and I am head of guitar department here at the Royal Danish Academy of Music in Copenhagen. This spring, I had the privilege to play a small, in time at least, guitar interlude by the British composer Thomas Adés in his opera, The Exterminating Angel, at the Royal Danish Opera here in Copenhagen. The opera is based on the surreal movie The Exterminating Angel by Louis Buñuel. And it's the first time that the composer writes for guitar. And the guitar part was premiered by the guitar player Michael Kurdica. This guitar interlude takes place in the third act. And the scenery is really special. A cut off hand begin to crawl across the floor on stage. A woman shining in sweat is very scared, and she's hammering a heavy bronze figure onto the hand. It's 3 o'clock at night. She's relieved, but suddenly she notices that the hand crawls again, and the hand reaches her throat and tries to choke her. She throws the hand on the table, takes a knife, and chops it up. Another woman is screaming, and suddenly there is other people in the room, and you're wondering if it all was a dream. And this special scene with the hand is very different from all the rest of the movie. And maybe that's why Thomas Adés has chosen to write a little part for guitar and completely solo guitar. It's a huge change in the music picture in all of the opera. He uses the big orchestra, a lot of percussion off stage, and he uses very much also the fascinating Ondes Martinot. This little interlude, or little in time interlude, is some of the most spectacular piece I have ever played. And I can say also one of the most demanding pieces. To give the interlude the character, spooky, scary character, Thomas Adés uses all kind of different guitar techniques and colors. Different rasgueados, long and short, trills, slurs, pizzicato, glissandi, you name it. And then he uses all the fretboard. And he also demands you to play as loud as you possibly can, 3 times F, and then suddenly sul tastiera, the piano pianissimo. I'll try to take out some parts that I think is really spectacular. For example, the beginning, it's a descending double slur, and then the interval fifth, and then a trill, and then a Bartok pits. Sounds something like this. And then it goes on again onto a trill. He likes trills a lot. So I'll play the first bar. Really something of an opening, I think. And it just goes on with this extreme that you play really with as expressive as you can. Actually, the next bar is similar again, a double slur, like this. And then he wants you to use the thumb here as loud as you can. And then a tambora, and then a thrill. So it sounds something like this. And goes on. He here. Then there's, he puts in small cadences, and with the raschiato, for example, later on in the little interlude, sounds something like this. The interlude in the opera has this, the first a solo where the guitar is completely solo, then the singer, he accompanies a singer, and then at the end of the piece, the wonderful instrument, or the very special instrument, Ondes Martinot, is also joining. Actually, Thomas Adés said to me that he thought the piece could be played also as a solo piece entirely. Another really fascinating place is the ending, where he again works with the fifth interval, so give a kind of heavy music, heavy rock music style, and then all of a sudden he goes into this glissando, spooky, and then at the end he has a huge section with raschiatos, and then it ends, the pieces end with a long glissando, and here the hand is crawling in the character, to choke the character on stage. I'll play a little bit, I'll play the ending. Something like that. So it's really exciting for us to have a piece by this wonderful composer Thomas Adés, and I strongly say to you all that please look into this. It's a wonderful piece, and yeah, thank you.